finally bring this into Substance Painter. So I'm going to select this and this. Now I'll do a combine for this. Do a combine. Okay, let me undo that instead. So I'll select these two. I'll right click and hold. I'll click on add favorite material. I'll click on Lambert. Then I'll just change. I'll go and look for that particular texture, Lambert. I'll just change the color of this to red. And I'll name this undo pointer. Save this. And I'll select this. I would hold shift and right click. I will separate them. I need to be separate piece, but then I will select them like so. Select it each individual piece. Right click on node, add another favorite material. I'll add another lambda to this. I'll give this yellow and I'll name this clothes back and leather, something like this should be fine. Doesn't really matter anyways. Then I'm going to select all this piece, go to my exports. So I'm going to export this as an dual FBX file. So I'll go to my documents, under my knife, under this low, I'll choose dual FBX for this. Then I'll scroll down here and make sure you turn off triangulate. Make sure you turn off the triangulate in here. Then I'll name this knife 01 ready. So I've done an export for this now. This should export. Like, it's exporting now. Okay, it's done exporting. Then I'll go to Substance Painter. Let me open up Substance Painter in here. I'll run this. So now let's import geometry into Substance Painter. So I'll go to File, New. To find new, and then select, I want to import in my mesh. I would go to this knife piece here, should be sitting here. I'll select this, I'll click on open. Then I'll need to import my textures, at least I need to import my normal maps. So under, okay, back in here and under bigs, I import my cloth normal and cloth UV island. So that my cloth UV island will be my color ID. Then also I will import my under undo. Yeah, under pointer and undo, I'll import my normal map. And my color ID also. Okay, now click OK. So it should load up in here. So now I have this piece in here now. Under my texture sets, you can see. No. This one is not supposed to be there. Let me see. Like I have an hidden piece in there. I have an hidden piece in there which is not supposed to be. Anyways, I'll just leave this as it is. I won't be exporting that Okay, let me quickly fix that. It's just an hidden piece that is not supposed to be there. So let's quickly fix that. So I'll go to my hyper shade. Now in my hyper shade, let me give this more space. So I would select this. Okay, let me be sure the particular material it is. So it's around Lambert 4. So if I should right click in here, I'll go to select object with this material. That object is not even found in here. Okay, let me just do something better instead. I'll select this out. Select this again, piece by piece. And I'll do an export, leaving this on dual FBX. Making sure everything is working correctly as it should. Let me just put two at the beginning of this. I'll do an export. Okay, so if I go back, in here. Okay, I should have that piece in there now. So going back to Substance Painter, I'll go to Edit, Project Configuration. So I need to re-import. Let me re-import these two. I'll click OK. So as you can see now, it has updated that. Now I can't find this piece anymore. It's Lambert piece anymore, which is fine. This is exactly what I want. So we can carry on from here. Carrying on from here, we're going to import in our maps. So for this CBLT, I'll go to the maps. I'll click on, okay, lift on 2K, normal map. For this is a normal map. I'll select my normal map. That should update. As you can see, that has been added. I've added that. You can see it's working in there correctly. So let me add my color ID. Should be this one. Then now I'm going to bake. Okay, let me close this. Let me go to my undo and do the same thing in here also. Import my normal map pointer. As you can see, it has applied that on here, and you won't be seeing that issue we had I think I missed one part in correcting my UVs, where I have those tiling pattern like this line. As you can see, I didn't correct that properly in Photoshop as I should. But it's still fine. It wasn't going to be painting over some details in there to hide those completely. So I think it's fine. It's not that bad. So I'll go to my ID. I'll select my ID. Then on bake mesh, I'll need to bake. I'll turn off ambience. I'll turn off normal. I'll put this on 2K. Then I'm going to bake this for all my mesh, for all my texture sets. So I click on bake, and I'll give it a sec to load up. I'll come back when this is done. So it's done baking. I'll click OK in here. So you can see baked correctly. So everything looks good. The bake came out great, so you can start working on this. So let me just do a quick test on this. So on this piece, I will just, if I should add the wood in there now, let me just under my smart material, if I should search for a wood and just drop that in there. Just type in wood. Wood, so it looks good. So I would control, click and drag this. So I will drag this. Okay, let me drag this on here. Okay. So see what I'm going to do. I'm going to remove these color marks. I'll go to my mesh. I'm just testing this. I'll click on mesh and I'll select this piece. Go back to my paintbrush. As you can see, this is already looking pretty good. I should run my light around this. See, everything is coming out great as it should, which is quite nice. I'm having this kind of decay in here, which gives it a very good feel, a very good feeling of something that maybe over time has been eating up due to the fact that there isn't any sunlight in there to make this place look washed out. So it's kind of retaining that kind of old, or yes, kind of original wood material in there, or color in there. So that is quite nice, as you can see. So from here on, we can start looking at our reference to properly and correctly texture this as we should, and then finally we're going to export this out to Marmoset Toolbag and then do a very neat render on this. So I'll see you guys then.